Namaste children, the next chapter what you are going to learn is perimeter and area. First let us learn about perimeter. Perimeter is not new to you, isn't it? You have already learned in your class 4. Now let us just recapitulate what you have learned. Firstly, perimeter is from the Greek word peri and metron. Here peri means boundary and metron means measure. So measure of the boundary is called as perimeter. Okay, so the definition of perimeter is the length of the boundary of a closed figure. Remember, it should be a closed figure. You are already known to what is closed figure and open figure. Let me just do a recapitulation of it. For example, you have a figure this way. When I start drawing the boundary from A, along the boundary I draw, I'm reaching here. Am I reaching back to A? No. So such type of figures are called as open figures. Open figures can also be a curve. Okay, this is also called as an open figure. This is also called as an open figure. For all these, if you observe children, the particular figure will not be having any enclosed surface, so we cannot find out perimeter or area for it. Now I will give you an example of our next figure. If I take this as a point and draw along the border of it, am I coming back to that point, drawing onto the border? Yes. So such figures are called as closed figures. Closed figures can have any number of sides. So for such figures, you can find out perimeter as well as area, as there is some surface enclosed. Okay. First, let us do some examples with find the perimeter of the given figures. The first figure given to us is, so once you get in the question perimeter, what you do is take your pencil and draw the line along the border of the given figure. Now it is clear to you what is the border of the closed figure and what are the sides which you have to add here. Here it is a triangle, isn't it? So perimeter of the triangle is equal to sum of sides of the triangle. So whenever you are taking the sides, you follow a pattern so that you will not miss out with any number. So we will start from here. 3 cm plus 3 cm plus 2.5 cm. Now in your rough copy, 3 cm, 3 cm and 2.5 cm. So we have checked it. And then check how many sides are, lines are there here. 3 we have got here. 3. So now in our rough column, we add 3. 3.0, 3.0, 2.5. Add up this, 0 plus 0 plus 5 is 5.0. 3 plus 3 is 6 plus 2 is 8. You get 8.5 and the unit will be the same as given in the length. In the length, if it is given meter, it will be meter. It is given centimeter here, so your answer, that is the perimeter of the given figure, is 8.5 cm. So here we will have to find the perimeter of the figure. So take your pencil and draw a line along the border so that you will not get confused of what are the lengths to be added. So on my board, the black color is my border. So I will add only those sides. Okay. So now perimeter is equal to, I will start with the pattern so that I'll not miss out any sides. 3.5 plus 2.5 plus 5 plus 2.5. Put a bracket and write the unit. Now in your rough column, add up 3.5 plus 2.5, 5 to be written as 5.0. You learned this how to do it in your class 5. Hope you haven't forgotten it. 2.5. Before you add, just check how many sides are there and whether I have jotted down all. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Fine. So 5 plus 5 plus 5 is 15. 3 plus 1, 4. Plus 2, 6. Plus 5, 11. Plus 2, 13. Is equal to 13.5. What is the unit? Centimeter. This is how you should find out the perimeter of such figures. In this figure, as I told you earlier, we are adding only the boundary. We are not adding what is there within the figure. That is why I told that you will have to make the boundary. So such problems, you should be careful, children. Mistake normally children do is you just add up all the numbers whatever are given. So that is the reason I have asked you to put the boundary. Please be careful when such problems are given. Perimeter of rectangle. First, let me draw a rectangle. Now, what are the properties of rectangle? You know that a rectangle is a four-sided figure, closed figure, where both opposite sides are equal. And the side which is longer is called as length, and the shorter side is called as breadth. So, in a rectangle, you have two length and two breadth. Now, when I am asking you perimeter, what should you do? You are adding up all the sides. So you have two length and two breadth. That is two times of length added to two times of breadth, you get the perimeter of rectangle. The formula for rectangle, perimeter of rectangle, is 2 into length plus 2 into breadth. This can also be written as, children, 2 into length plus breadth. You can either use this formula or this formula. The resultant will be the same. And coming to the units, what to be used? Unit will be centimeter or meter normally. Whatever is the unit given for the length and the breadth, the same unit you will have for your perimeter also. Now let us solve a problem based on it. If you are given that length is 40 meter and breadth is 15 meter, find the perimeter of the rectangle. So first let us write the formula. 2 into length plus 2 into breadth. Now what is the length according to our problem? 2 into 40 meter plus 2 into 15. Okay. So 2 into 40, where 40 is a length. 2 into 15, where 15 is a breadth. Now 2 into 40, 240, 2 into 40 you get 80 plus 2 into 15 you get 30. 80 plus 30. When you add 80 plus 30, how much do you get? You get 110 meter. So since length and breadth is given in meter, my perimeter also should be in meter. This is how you substitute in the formula and find out the perimeter of the rectangle. Let us see the next problem, children. Find the perimeter of a rectangle if length is 32.5 cm and breadth is 27.5 cm. So, let us first write what are the information given to us. Length is equal to 32.5 cm. Breadth is equal to 27.5 cm. He is asking you to find out the perimeter of rectangle is equal to 2 into length plus 2 into breadth. Okay, so 2 into 32.5 plus 2 into 27.5. In your rough column, let us do the multiplication. 32.5 into 2. 5 2's are 10, 2 2's are 4 plus 1 5, 2 3's are 6, decimal multiplication. Okay, so here you have 65.0, which is nothing but 65. Now we will do the next multiplication. 27.5 into 2, 2 5's are 10. 2 7s are 14 plus 1 15, 2 2s are 4 plus 1 5, decimal point. 55.0 can be written as 55. What is the unit? Centimeter. Now I add 5 plus 5, 10. 6 plus 1, 7. 7 plus 5, 120 centimeter. So perimeter of the given rectangle is 120 centimeter. This is how you will have to solve when you get length and breadth in the form of decimals.